In the United States, about two-thirds of women of reproductive age, about 47 million women, are using some form of contraception. What happens when they stop? Will they have more trouble getting pregnant than other women? Does it matter what type of contraceptive they use? These are really important questions. There are a number of studies that have looked at this. Stay tuned. We can divide contraceptives into different categories: barrier contraceptives like condoms, short-acting hormone contraceptives like birth control pills, patches, and vaginal rings, and long-acting contraceptives like IUDs, hormone injections, and implants. Barrier contraceptives, such as condoms, are presumed to not have any effect on female fertility and so are usually used as a comparison group. Several studies have reported delays of about 3 months in return of fertility after stopping oral contraceptives. In other words, less women became pregnant in the first 3 months of trying if they took birth control pills compared to women who didn't. However, after 1 year of trying, more women who took birth control pills achieved pregnancy compared to women who didn't. One study found that women who took birth control pills for a longer period of time had better fertility than those who took them for a short period of time. What about intrauterine devices, or IUDs? There are two types of IUDs. Some contain derivatives of the hormone progesterone. In the USA, a popular brand is called Mirena. Other IUDs contain copper. This type does not have any hormones. A recent study found that once they removed the IUD and started trying to get pregnant, IUD use was associated with a delay of about 2 months in trying to become pregnant. Interestingly, women who used hormone-containing IUDs had about a 20% higher chance of becoming pregnant compared to copper IUDs or women who used condoms. Injection of hormones is another common method of contraception. In the USA, the most commonly used injection is called Depot-Provera, which contains a type of progesterone. In a recent study, this type of contraception caused the longest delays for the return of fertility. On average, women who used injections had delays of fertility of 5 to 8 menstrual cycles compared to women using condoms. However, women who used this type of contraception were more likely to have a higher body mass index, were more likely to be current smokers, to report a history of infertility, and to have irregular menstrual cycles beforehand. These other factors may have been partly or fully responsible for the delays that were seen. For comparison, women who used contraceptive patches had returned to fertility delays of about 4 menstrual cycles. Birth control pills and vaginal rings had delays of about 3 months. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this: using contraceptives other than barriers like condoms may cause short delays in the return of full fertility. These delays range from 2 months to 8 months, depending on the type of contraceptive. Use of birth control pills, especially long-term use, may help improve your overall chance for becoming pregnant. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.